up, my geek people, my geeky people?
All right.
We are new to a project that we are now, you're actually now involved in this project.
Mm-hmm.
We call it
Revaluate.
What we do is we look at TV shows and movies
mm-hmm.
That are currently either in the movie cinemas or it's currently on television.
Mm-hmm.
And what we do is during the week, we go through these movies or TV shows, whatever, and then we reevaluate it.
Okay, and then we right? either value it or hate it. You tell us, okay, and we will tell you also. It's going to be about TV shows that might be just coming out or it's been things that we're just watching. We just want to talk about it.
Yeah,
so,
basically. And of course, we do our reviews every Sunday.
That's right.
Every Sunday. So,
look forward to that.
Yes.
Every Sunday, we drop in at least one video about our Evaluate series. So, we are going to go into what?
What we did. We actually did some reevaluation, two movies and a TV show.
Okay.
So, what I did Resident Evil. Of course, that was released, I think it was last week, Thursday.
Last week Wednesday.
Yeah. And what you did?
I did Ghostbusters.
And then, of course, we're going to, we actually
talk
came
about
across, came across
Hawkeye.
Hawkeye.
Why did I say that? Hawkeye. Okay. So let's go. Let's get into it.
So we're going to talk about Resident Evil. This damn movie, man. It was.
Oh, damn. Tell me how you really feel.
Jesus mercy. Let's get into it. The movie came out, and overall, it was just so unattached to the original structure of the game itself. Of course, the original was trash, but this, of course, is trasher. This is like trasher. Deep trash.
Okay, so.
You know what I mean? So, this movie, it was just discombobulated. It was just all over the place. First of all, the story was unattached to the original true story of the game itself. I think they were more structured into going into zombie than anything else. The makeup design is total trash. You had a scene where the zombies at the gate.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see like their faces like melting off and shit. I'm like, there is no decomposition of their faces or anything.
It
just happened, you know what I mean? So that was messed up for me. Overall, I think the movie felt rushed, to get into the zombie scenes and everything. You know, overall, I just had zombies appear out of nowhere. So, you know, there wasn't like some sort of instinct that brought these people, like someone got bitten. And, you know, you can see the effect that's going on throughout the movie that make the zombies actually.
Gotcha.
Another thing is that the characters seem worthless. They didn't serve a purpose throughout the movie. Leon was
so
trash.
Bad.
Leon was supposed to be the badass dude in the entire movie. He was a punk. He
mm-hmm.
was a bitch. You know what I mean? So, they did Leon wrong. It was not centralized or focused on what the main event was, or probably what the main purpose of us of was. What the main purpose was about the movie. So, you know, it was like you had one scene that they're doing one thing, and then you have another scene that they're doing another thing. And it's like you can't set a proper focus on what the entire movie was about or what its main purpose was about.
They were putting two games into one.
Yeah, exactly.
They were putting Resident Evil 1 and Resident Evil 2 into one movie.
It just didn't make any sense.
It
just didn't make any sense. So that's my gross on that one. There was another scene in the movie that literally I think they didn't like people with epilepsy. The part of the movie was nothing but flashes. Oh my God.
It was bad. It was
I'm like, why is that scene even there? Because there was just nothing but flashes. And afterwards, like that, you know, afterwards, it's like, you know, I was like, but why? some shooting was going on, but the flashes just hurt my eye, you
mm-hmm.
know, kind of thing. And I was like, okay, so what is the whole purpose of that? So I didn't like that scene. That scene was stupid. I don't know what they were trying to convince people about, you know, with that scene, but no.
Is there anything you did like?
Nah, I didn't like
Damn.
And most of all, the movie just got worse and worse by the second. I think the only good thing about the movie was that they kind of stayed true to the game itself in terms of the aesthetics, the surroundings, the, you know, the probably the monsters, but not
the look of at least.
Yeah, some least. In some sense, you mm-hmm. know. So yeah, otherwise than that, it's that's what I get from this entire shit bollocks of movie.
Okay, I mean, damn.
Yeah, exactly. So
which one would you prefer, Paul's one, Anderson, or this one?
Nah, I you know what, I prefer Anderson's thing, the original one.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I prefer the first original Evil movie, and that's just my that's just
interesting my. That in of itself could be a dialogue. All right, I got to see Ghostbusters Afterlife. Who you gonna call? And here's what my take on it was. McKenna Grace as Phoebe anchors this entire film. That girl is like in her teens and she handled it like a pro. That film was basically on her back. And even though she was like aloof and quirky, I liked it. I thought that she did an amazing job. It feels like a true sequel. Like, it feels like a true sequel to the 1984. I'm gonna get into why that's a little bit bad too, but as far as like just continuity and as far as aesthetic and feel of like a Ghostbusters film, it does feel like a true sequel to the 1984. And they even give you some references to the 1989 movie. So it's not like they're just ignoring that and just saying that that never happened like some other franchises we know. True. But I like that they was doing that they brought in both. But again, it was a true sequel to the 1984 movie. And I like that they really did a very good job of honoring Harold Ramis. Like, yeah, that was very touching. And the fact that they even let it go a little bit further than just when they were trapping Gozer. Like, you had a little bit of interchange with father and daughter. And that I thought was really, really
was
nice.
That was strong.
Okay, and like, you really felt like he was like a ghost. Like, you really felt like he was a ghost. It wasn't just like some really bad CGI. But I really liked that. I thought it was touching. Now, here's the things that I also just like, I just said I liked the fact that it was a sequel, right? It really did the same fucking bullshit as The Force Awakens. Okay? Follow me.
Okay.
The Force Awakens was nothing but a retread, okay, of A New Hope. And this is nothing but a retread of 1984. Now, when I say it's a true sequel, is because that they gave an organic way to expand the characters from the original into the new, as well as opening up to a brand new cast, right? That's the good part of that true sequel thought process. The bad thing was the fact that, like, yo, you ain't do nothing different. You had, first of all, they put Gozer in, who looked like the same actress. I know she wasn't. I'm almost positive she wasn't. But like the same actress from the original. Aesthetic and all. And I was like, y'all could have branched that out. Now, the last thing I would say is that the way that they put the original Ghostbusters at the end, I feel like you couldn't do it no other way, but I wish that it would have. It felt very inorganic. It was just like, oh, they're here. So overall, me personally, I did like the movie. Don't get me wrong. I thought it was okay. It was a good movie for what it was. For a sequel, though, I need y'all to be a little bit more original.
Okay, well, you know, for me, I think the entire Resident Evil, still, I hate it. I freaking hate it. I wouldn't value it no form, source, nor nothing.
Okay.
That's just my thing with Resident Evil.
And you really hated it?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know.
It was trash.
All right.
And what you think about Ghostbusters, you value it?
I value it.
Okay.
I thought it was pretty cool, but like I said, I just wish they would have been a little bit more original.
Okay, this sounds good. This week, I think it was last week, Wednesday, right?
Yep.
Hawkeye started with two episodes.
Yes.
Two episodes, and we get the chance to review it. So far, it has been very interesting.
Okay.
Actually, it gave me a buzz, actually, because I think Hawkeye was overlooked a lot in the...
A lot.
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah, all the time. Even with this, they even mentioned, they even showed the fact that he was overlooked. So they're trying to put him within the main source or the main view of the entire Avengers team. And I think this is good. It's going in the good direction with Kate Bishop. She is excellent. She was fun. They both had this connection as a team, mm-hmm. so to speak. So yeah, I think this is great. This is on a good course of having something that we need from Marvel
through Disney.
Mm-hmm. That is going towards the new phase of Phase 4.
I am okay with it.
Mm.
Okay. You know me, I like big explosion, big bang bang. So I do like the fact that they are focusing on an Avenger that has no superpowers. Mm. I do actually like that. It makes me feel a lot more bonded to it as a character because I can see myself there. What I'm not that crazy about, and I learned the hard way to never doubt Disney in a sense, mm. or never doubt Kevin Feige, mm. because like the first two episodes were just okay. I mean, they were just okay. Like, you really... I'm not impressed with the Tracksuit Mafia. Like, whatever. I get that they're a big deal in the comics. So I will say that. But mm. as their portrayal here, it's really dumb. It looks kind of like New Jersey Shore if they were to become villains. Like, whatever. But I also learned from WandaVision that the first two episodes means can mean dick. Mm. Okay? The first two episodes is setting it up to really give you a really big punch. So I'm looking forward to hopefully getting that punch.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, was there anything really, really wrong with it? Not really. But did it vibe with me? Am I excited now that I'm getting into it and I got the first episodes? Okay.
So I believe that there's going to be a lot of cameos that's going to be involved mm-hmm. in Hawkeye. So I'm pretty much low-key. I'm liking it so far. I like the vibe. I value it. So I'm not going to say that I don't like this or I don't like that. I'd have to get a full view or a full look of the entire series season to know if I like it or not. But so far, I think I value it because of the fact that they put in Hawkeye in the view right now. And that is needed.
I value it too. Timidly. It's not like it's a badly made series. So that's why I'm not gonna say I hate it. But I'm just like, all right, let's pick up.
Yeah, well, so far, this is what we value. Of course, next week, I am going to do Arcane.
Okay.
I'm gonna do Arcane.
You're gonna do Arcane?
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
I think I'm gonna try to do Red Notice. There's a lot of stuff that we are so backed up on.
Yeah.
So I think I'm gonna make sure that I watch Red Notice at least.
Yeah, so Arcane, Red Notice.
Mm-hmm. We also haven't watched the live action of Cowboy Bebop.
Oh yeah, damn, we haven't watched Bebop.
Okay.
Oh yeah,
so, there you go. There you go.
I'm gonna be doing Arcane. You're gonna be doing
Red Notice.
And then we're gonna be
Cowboy Bebop.
All right. So please join us next week Sunday mm-hmm. for all of this review. Of course, thank you guys for joining us and
like, share, subscribe.
Yes.
Okay, hit that notification. You'll know when we upload. Visit us on Instagram and Twitter. Deep by Hearts. I am Lainey.
I'm Jay. And
we will
join us back again when we reevaluate.
Next Sunday.
Reevaluate.
To reevaluate.
Peace.
Peace.